Ahoy sailors, and welcome to another episode of On the Map, the only in-game Sea of Thieves talk show. I'm Captain Beatty, joined always by my trusty first mate, Nayfes and Derek, the son of Merrick.
The life of a pirate is fraught with danger.
Thanks for that, son. There's plenty of news floating around the seas this week. The infamous DoubleShot has finally been addressed by the developers. And in the wake of this, Nayfes has taken it upon himself to perform an in-depth investigation for a special On the Map report. Let's take a look now and see how that went.
Thank you, Captain. For today, we dove into the realm of Sea of Thieves flight mechanics to size up the controversial double shot technique and its apparent overwhelming effectiveness. The weapon-wielding strategy that is adapted from previous game techniques like the two-pump from Fortnite, where a player will equip two guns, generally a flintlock and eye of reach, and fire both weapons in a weapon-swap trigger-clutch explosion, dealing beyond deadly damage in under a second. Though it's accomplishable on both console and PC, it's most commonly demonstrated in PC players due to its more favourable setup. Nonetheless, a vessel boarded by an accurate two-pop pirate has its crew mostly meet a green misty end. With seemingly no counter, many players had grown increasingly frustrated at this infamous meta and have regularly expressed their aggressions on both the forums and social media. Due to its increasing popularity appearing more and more, I had taken it upon myself to investigate this deadly duo and find out just how deadly it is and if there's truly no counter. If you would like to see my full investigation and guide to taking them on until it's fixed in the near future, head over to the forum thread on the official Sea of Thieves website through the link in the description below. Hopefully it can help you and your crew get more of an edge against the two-piecing players. That concludes this report. I leave you today with the developer's input to the double gunning technique, and until next time on OTM Reports, I'm Nate Casewell. Happy sailing.
First of those is the kind of double gun thing that you can use, where you can actually use two guns in quick succession and kind of get two shots off so quickly that it ultimately amounts to like a single shot kill. So this is something that has become more prevalent recently. We've seen a lot of players starting to use this, and this is never our intended design. Like, the different weapons that we have all been balanced, all been tuned so that you have to do multiple shots and they have different damage, different range, etc. But we never intended for there to be like a one-shot kill player to player in Sea of Thieves. And so the way this is working is not intended and it's not as designed. So we are looking to address this, and we've got a couple of kind of options that we're working on at the moment, but you will not be able to use this in the future once we've applied a fix and we've rolled this out into one of our game updates. Like, we just wanted to get ahead of that and let people know that we are making this change. So, you know, we're just currently trying out a couple of fixes to it, but it was never our design intent, and we really don't like that as a player you come across another player and effectively one-shot kill them, because that was never the design intent. And that's the real issue here that we're trying to address.
Some great journalism there, Nayf. Thanks for that, son. Be sure to click the link in the description below to read Nayf's full investigation and find out the best ways to counter someone who's double pumping. In other news this week, plenty of pirates across the seas have finally hit pirate legend, including a few members of our own Red Dog crew. So let's take a look now at just a few of the pirates who have hit the glorious rank of pirate legend. Congratulations to these fine sailors, as well as everybody else in the Sea of Thieves community that's hit the rank of pirate legend over the last few weeks. And aside from being a dedicated fan base that hit the rank of pirate legend, the Sea of Thieves community always has great game clips to offer. Just have a look at some of these that were sent in to On the Map. And aside from game clips, the community has some amazing physical creations. Check these out while we go and take care of business. Come on, mate. Wow, how good are those? If you have a game clip, artwork, cosplay, skull, pet, weapon, or even a model that you'd like to share with us, simply tag us on Twitter and we'll make sure that your creation is featured in the next episode of On the Map. We love to see the community content. And speaking of content, we really wanted to know what the community thought would be the best content to put in a future DLC. So we put up a poll on our Twitter. On the poll, we had various new areas and content ideas. But as you can see from the results, there was an overwhelming response for an Arctic or ice area. It seems to us that the community really wants to explore an Arctic area in a future DLC. Icebreaker-style figureheads, Arctic wolves, frozen skeletons, warm Viking-style clothing, frozen cursed chests, much more could be added into an Arctic update. If this concept art is anything to go by, we think that it would be a fantastic addition to the game. We'll just have to wait and see what the developers have in store for us this year. And speaking of community content, Nerd Propellant has been making these amazing skulls that you can buy on the Nerd Propellant Etsy store. The Nerd Propellant Workshop looks like our captain's quarters after an Athena's. Be sure to head over to their Twitter to see all the latest creations. Well played. Myself and Derek spent many doubloons this week on these skulls. We can't wait to put them on the mantelpiece. We've had a fantastic time checking out all of the community content this week, so be sure to tune in to our future episodes to see much more. And later in the week, we'll be highlighting the latest Race of Legends, where we compete to hold our title. Be sure to follow us on Twitter and subscribe to our YouTube channel to see when the latest videos drop. We've got stacks of content on the way. And as always, we're running our weekly Athena's Fortune competition. Simply like this video and drop a comment below with your gamer tag to go into the draw to run a full Athena's voyage with us on the Red Dog. We'll take good care of you, we promise. We might even feature the footage in a future episode of On the Map. Well, that's all we've got time for today, sailors. But thanks for tuning in. I'm Captain Beatty of the mighty Red Dog, joined by my trusty first mate, Nate Pacewell, in the dark caves underneath Sailor's Bounty. We'll see you next time on the map. And as always, happy sailing to you all. Yarr!